What's going on, Saviors? GH here. Today, I decided I'll be doing a state of the game for Steam 3 of Savior in January 8, 2021. This is the first state of the game for 3 of Savior. Let's jump right into it and let's do this. Okay, first up, let's talk about the population. Looking at the Steam charts, at the moment, we have 2,131 at a given time about 24 hours ago. And currently, we have 1,661. Believe it or not, the game is doing fine. The game always stay around 1,500. And actually, the current population of the game is the sweet spot for playing the game because there will be no lag. If you've been playing 3 of Savior for a while now, you know every time we get close to 3,000, the game is barely playable. Now, updates. Currently, we are waiting for the 64-bit DX11 update and the new classes. And that's gonna bring us better game performance, higher frame rates, and all those good stuff. And two new classes. Arquebusier for the Archer Class 3 and Clown for the Scout Class 3. As for when it's gonna come, it's soon. Trademark. Nobody knows, but IMC. For the events, the most notable one is the Happy 2021 Festival. It's basically collecting coins and opening boxes. And I know what you're interested in. It's the rewards. Here's the S rank and A rank rewards you can get from the lucky boxes. And here it is. If you're interested in the rewards, good for you. But for me, the only good thing I could see here is the Shabby Transcendent Scroll Selection box. And it's not even guaranteed, so I'll be skipping this one. Now for the interesting part, bots. As you see, they still exist. And this one's actually been here for a few weeks now, and I've been following these bots, and they seem to be unstoppable. But don't worry, they can't farm silver anymore, so that's a good thing. Now for the most recent controversy, I don't know what to call this, happening in the game, the GMs banned cheaters. And if you want to know more about the cheating issue, just go to the forums and look for the hacking and abusing section. A lot of people got banned. And as usual, the forum got a lot of I'm innocent, why ban me posts. Now, what else? Item prices. A full Arc Stone is still very expensive on all regions. So as the fragments. Tokens on North America is about 10 million to 20 million, but it's usually about 15 million. For tokens on Fedimian, it's much more cheaper over there, with tokens around 10 million apiece. For tokens on Southeast Asia, it's around 26 million, it's getting expensive, and about 35 million on South America. No comment. Now for the current top 5 popular build is this guys. We got Pyro Elite Tao at the number 1 spot due to its usefulness on endgame content, then the Flagboy build at number 2. A lot of newer players use this because it's a helpful build that doesn't require that much equipment. Then at the third spot, it's Priest, Diev, and Oracle. A very reliable support build for players, for veteran healers, not so much for newer players. Then at the fourth spot, the Blossom Blader build, another reliable build for sure. Then at the fifth spot, Tome, Enchanter, and SR. Believe it or not, that build is pretty good. But people usually use that build for botting, that's why it's at the 5th spot. Overall, the game is doing good. It's a great time to play the game, and people are still doing challenge mode, doing weekly activities. But of course, that could all change depending on how the next update is received. Will it fix the current problems we have in the game, or does it add to the overwhelming amount of farming that we need to do? And that's it guys. Tell me what do you want to see or what do you want to know in the state of the game of TOS so that I will add it in the future state of the game videos. And I have to go rest guys, this is feeling a bit sick at the moment. Anyway, this is Gaming Hardcore. See you in the next one.